Hey everyone! A couple weeks ago, we looked at the Gemini app for the Flipper Zero. This application uses firmware on the ESP32 to send data to the internet. Unfortunately, Gemini doesn't have access to our location information or current events. In this video, we'll modify the firmware to get user location information and we'll pass that information on to Gemini. Let's get started. First, we'll set up our firmware development environment. For this video, I'll use the Arduino IDE. I'm on Windows 11, so I'll pick the first option and then choose one of the download options. And then once it's completed downloading, go ahead and click on Open File. And I'll go ahead and install it with all of the default settings. Run Arduino IDE is checked, and I'll go ahead and click Finish. The first run will prompt for network access, installing network drivers, and installing some other applications as well. Once everything's installed, we're ready to add support for ESP32. From the Tools menu, choose Board, and then Board Manager. Search for ESP32. And then click Install on the ESP32 by Expressive. That'll take a couple of minutes to install. And you should get a pop-up with Successfully Installed Platform ESP32. Then go to Tools and Manage Libraries. And then in the Manage Libraries, type Arduino JSON, all one word. And then click the Install for Arduino JSON. There's our successfully installed library pop-up. And this library is used by the Gemini firmware. Next, we'll open a web browser to lab.flipper.net/apps, and we'll search for Gemini IA, and then scroll down to the bottom of the page, and you should see a repository link. Go ahead and open that up, and then look for the file with the .ino extension. There it is, ESP32. And the second option on the right is copy raw file to the clipboard and click that. Now it's copied. We can go ahead and close our web browser, select all inside of your Arduino, and then hit paste. The Wi-Fi module has a USB port, so I'll go ahead and use that for this demo. Click boot and then reset, let go of reset, and then let go of boot. So now we're ready to flash the board. Go to Tools, Board, and ESP32, and then ESP32 S2 Dev Module. Next, go to Tools, and then Port, and then choose the serial port with your Dev Module. For the Dev Module, we should be able to use all the rest of these default values. So go over to the Sketch menu, and then choose Upload. This step will take a minute while it compiles the firmware. And then once it's done, it will upload the firmware to the device. And at this point, you've flashed new Gemini firmware onto your ESP32. Connect the dev board to your Flipper, and then choose GPIO, USB UART bridge, left arrow for config, and then for the baud rate, we'll set it to 115/200. And click back. Now you can plug in your USB cable. And then we can click reset on the board. In the Arduino IDE, choose Tools, Port, and choose the new serial port that's your Flipper Zero. And then go Tools, Serial Monitor. I'll click the reset button on the board again. And we can see waiting for API key. Paste in your Gemini API key and press Enter. And you can see it's prompting us to enter name. Type in your name and press enter. It'll scan for your local networks. And then type the SSID of your network, followed by 2/, and then your password. And then press enter. At this point, the ESP32 will work to connect to your local network. And once it's connected, it should get an IP address. At this point, we're all connected. So I'll go ahead and type in, what is today's date? Press enter. that's getting sent to Gemini. And Gemini's response is February 22nd, 2023. So this is an example of Gemini not knowing the most current information. Next, I'll ask for the weather near me. And that's being sent to Gemini. And you can see it says, I do not have real-time capabilities. In the next part of the video, we'll add location information that we'll pass to Gemini, but you could also pass other relevant real-time information, such as the date, weather, or anything else from an API. We'll be using the IP whois API. Loading the URL gives back a JSON response with the city, latitude, and longitude of the user. Above our loop method, I've added a new function. That function is GeoIP. This function will update the latitude, longitude, and city strings that are passed to it, and it'll return true if it's successful. We'll check if Wi-Fi is connected, and if it is, we'll call HTTP begin, passing in the URL of the IP whois API. Then we'll call HTTP add header, passing in our content type of application JSON. And then we'll call HTTP GET to make the web request. And if the call was successful, we'll call HTTP GET string to get the response. Then we'll use deserialized JSON to give us back the response as a JSON document. We'll extract the city property and store it in the city string, the latitude property in the latitude string, and the longitude property in the longitude string. And then we'll set success to true. The rest of this routine is just error handling, and then we'll return the success value. You can write similar functions for any other APIs you want to pass to Gemini. For example, you could use the following function to extract the weather based on the user's latitude and longitude information. In our loop function, we'll add a couple of if statements. If the user query equals attractions, we'll call GeoIP to get the latitude, longitude, and city. And if that's successful, we'll modify the user query to be tourist attractions near latitude, longitude. And if the user query was restaurants, we'll use GeoIP to get the latitude, longitude, and city. And then we'll modify the user query to be restaurants near latitude, longitude. We're ready to flash our firmware again, so do the boot, reset, reset, boot. And then in Arduino IDE, go to Tools, Port, and choose your ESP32's COM port. And then choose Sketch, Upload, or click the Upload button. You should get Compiling Sketch. And it looks like I have some compilation errors in my version. So it looks like whenever we're calling the document to get JSON data, we need to use const char star instead of just char star. So I'll go ahead and update the locations where I have char star to be const char star. So this is in that weather API, and then this one is in the GeoIP. Those are the only two functions I added, so that should be correct. Yeah, it looks good. Go ahead and click upload again. Make sure that your board is in boot mode. And this time we successfully compiled the sketch, and now we're uploading the new firmware to our ESP32. And it looks like it's successfully updated. I'm running the USB UART bridge with that COM port at 115.200 again. Go to Tools, Port, and choose your Flipper Zeros port. And then we'll go to Tools, Serial Monitor. Press Reset on the ESP32. Type in your API key to Gemini and press Enter. Type in your name, press Enter. It'll scan for the local Wi-Fi networks, then type in your Wi-Fi network, 2 slashes, and your Wi-Fi password, and press Enter. And it should connect to your Wi-Fi. I'll type in weather to get that local weather forecast. There it is. And then I'll type in, next I'll type attractions to get local attractions near me. And again, this will look up that geo IP address, and then it'll request attractions near that IP address. You can see the response on the attractions. And if we look, we can see that the request I made was tourist attractions near 37.39, -122.08. So this is an example of us augmenting the Gemini request. And again, we could also type in restaurants to have it augment that restaurants request. And here's the list of restaurants near and our latitude, longitude. If you have a different ESP32 than the dev board, you can go to Tools, and then Board, and then ESP32, and pick the module that you're using for your ESP32. This ESP32 is connected to the Flipper via the UART bridge, so I'll go ahead and change my upload speed to that 115-200, and then we'll go ahead and click the Upload button. This is recompiling our firmware for the ESP32 board that we selected. And now it's uploading the firmware to the ESP32. Again, make sure your ESP32 was in proper boot mode. I'm using a CAM module, so I had to connect a wire between ground and GPIO0 to get into boot mode. And you can see I'm just using power, ground, RX, and TX. And again, make sure your RX goes to TX and your TX goes to RX on the Flipper Zero versus the ESP32. Open the Gemini app once your firmware's updated. Go to the set name and type in your name. And you should see that scanning for Wi-Fi networks. Go ahead and click the back button, and then it should auto connect to your saved networks. There it is, found the network, and I have an IP address. So we can go ahead and click back again, and now we can go down to start chatting, and we can type in our query to Gemini. I'll go ahead and do the weather query. And that's making that GeoIP request, the forecast request, and returning a forecast response. Now you know how to update your Gemini firmware. Please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, leave a comment below or contact me on Discord.